Welcome to the lectures on transportation engineering 2, C451. Today we will learn the numericals on differential models or related to traffic flow fundamentals. We will solve the first numerical. We have given a data set. The speed density data for a mid-block section is given as
x square, that's called this place equation number 2.
2. Here, so we have developed the two equations. The equation number 1 is summation y equals to nc plus n summation xy. The equation number 2 it is summation xy equals to c summation x plus n summation x square. Here we have this what the data was given to us, and we have developed. We have calculated the column number 3 and column number 4, and from here we have taken the summation of the values that we have got all the summation x, summation y, summation x square, summation x square. And we can see from the equation that we want the summation of these values only. If we see from equation number 1, we can see that we want on the left hand side summation y. We already have summation y as 156. And n will represent the number of data. That is, here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for this data, we have n equals to 5. Similarly, c it is up or it is to be intercept. So we have to calculate it. M will be the slope. We have to calculate the slope for this particular given set of the data. And this summation x, we know the summation x we have already calculated as 217. Similarly, if you see in equation number 2, we have almost all the data, we have given every data. Summation xy is on left and right. You can see from the column number 4 gives us the summation of xy, that is 661. Similarly, c is a constant that or to say the intercept which we have to calculate, and summation x. And summation x we can get it from the column number 1. The summation of column number 1 gives us the summation x. And this slope that we have to calculate. And then we have the summation x square. The x square, the column 3 gives the data about x square. So it will take the summation of the column number data of column number 3. From there we will get the summation of x square. That is 9951. So we will try to write these equations. So y summation y, at the place of summation y, we will write 156. Equals to n, that is 5, so it will be 5c plus what is summation x? Summation x is nothing but 217, so it will be 217m. Let's call this equation number 3. Similarly, we will try to develop the equation number 2 also. What is summation xy? The summation xy is 661. We will write 6361 equals to, then we have c summation x. Summation x we are will get from the summation of column number 1, that is 21c, that is 217 into c plus m summation x square. What is the x square? This is the summation of column number 3, that is 9951. So that's it, we have developed the two equations, equation number 3 and equation number 4. And the unknowns are also 2, that is c and m. So we have 2 unknown and 2 equations. So we can determine these 2 unknown parameters, that is m and c. If we solve the equation number 3 and equation number 4, we will get these unknown parameters, that is c and s. So on solving equation number 3 and equation number 4, we will get the value of c and m, value of c by solving this equation. It will be 64.52, and the value of m, it will be minus 0.76. We have one check that the value of m should be negative. Why? Because we know that the relationship between the speed and density is linear, but the slope is negative. This is the speed, this is the density. So we know that the slope for this equation is negative. So if we are solving for a given set of data, if we are solving, we must get the slope for this relationship, for this given set of data, that is in between the speed and density, it must be negative. If we are getting it a positive value or some other value rather than if we are getting any other value than the negative one, that means it is that means we have committed the mistake somewhere. So we need to check it. This value must be negative. So as we are getting the negative value minus 0.76, that means it's we have done the calculation properly. We can proceed further. Now what we will do, we already get the value of c and m. So we will try to develop our equation, that is y equals to mx plus c. Value of m is nothing but 0.076, m plus plus C at the place of C, I will write as 64.52. So this is what the equation we can develop. This is the relationship for the given set of the earned data, that is x and y. We assume here that is speed data as a y axis on the y axis. So y wave is replaced by u equals to minus 0.76. M will be nothing but, what is M? This will be actually here x, y equals to mx plus c. So M we have written as 0.076. minus 0.76 at the x is here, x, the data of density will be generally take on x axis, so the x will be replaced by k, that is density plus 64.52. This we can take as equation number 1. This is the relationship between, or the linear relationship between the given set of data of the density and the speed. For this problem, we have asked to calculate for this problem the free flow speed, jam density and the maximum flow. We have asked to calculate free flow, jam density, free flow speed, jam density and the maximum flow. We are asked to find out these three. So now we got the equation. So for maximum flow, so we will solve this equation for the maximum flow. So for maximum flow, if we want to calculate the UF, we know that UF will be we can get, and the K will be zero. When kj will be 0, we will get this free flow speed, that is the distance. So if we want to get it, what we have to do from equation number A, the UF will be minus 0.76 into 0 plus 64.52. So if we solve it, we will get the free flow speed, that is as 64.52 kmph. What we have done, we know that for gas solid, the equations for maximum flow conditions we want to get the maximum free flow speed or maximum flow, for that the jam density must be 0. If we will apply this condition to this equation number A, we will get the free flow speed. So what we are doing, UF equals to the K will be 0, then we will get the free flow speed. So we put the value of K as 0, that is jam density. So we got the free flow speed as 64.52 kmph. Similarly, for free flow condition only, we will try to calculate the kj, that is jam density. We will get the jam density when the free flow speed will be the 0. So for this condition, we will solve from equation number 1. What we do? 0 equals to minus 0.76 into kj plus 64.52. From here we will solve, then we will get the jam density as 84.119. Kilometers per kilometer. This is the jam density. So record these two, free flow speed and the jam density. Now we want to calculate the maximum flow. So we know the formula for maximum flow, that is Q max is nothing but UF into Kj divided by 4. We have already got the value of free flow speed and the jam density. What is that? UF is 64.52 into the jam density we got as 84.119 divided by 4. So this is the Q max. This Q max will be 1356 vehicle per hour. So what we got? We have solved everything. three plus speed you have is 64.52. And the second one, that is the gen density, that's 84.119. Vehicle per kilometer, and the last one, that is maximum flow, that is Qmax, as 1356 vehicle per hour. These are the answers. So what was given? We will see the numbers in a second. What was given to us? We were given this much data, that is, we were given the data in between. Speed and density, that is speed 58, 51, 40, even density as 58, 51, 41, 39, 28, and corresponding to that you are having the speed, that is 21 kmps, 25 kmps, 31 kmps, 35 kmps and 44 kmps. And you are asked to calculate what is given side of the data, free flow speed, jam density and then maximum density. You are asked to calculate these three. So what we did, we have taken the density as column 1, speed as column 2, we have taken this density data as x-axis data, as we know the relationship in between the green shield model on x-axis, we represent the density on x-axis, while on y-axis we represent the speed. So what is it, we took the density data as x data and the speed data as the y data. Density is column 1 and speed as column 2, and we have calculated the column 3 as the square of the column number 1, that is x square. By taking the square of these values, that is 58 square, we got 3364, similarly 51 square, we got 2601, 41 square, 1651, like this we got the square bit, like this we got the column number 3. Then we calculate, we have gone for column number 4. What is column number 4? It is the multiplication of column number 1 and column number 2. That is, for first one we can see 58 into 21, we got 1218. Similarly, we got this one. So, we got summation and summation y, summation x square and summation x y. We know that this is a linear relationship we have in between this data. So, we have developed the equation by first standard of the C, which is the equation of a straight line. We have further tried to develop the equation summation y equals to nc plus n summation s and summation x y equals to this d summation s plus n summation x square. We have already got all this data from this table, so we have just put this data and we developed this equation. On solving this equation, here in equation number 3 and equation number 4, we have two unknowns and two equations we have, so we can get the unknown parameter. So on solving this equation number 3 and equation number 4, we got this unknown parameter, that is Tnm. So we developed the we have brought this equation, that is y equals to minus 0.76 x plus 64.52. Here we must remember that the value of this m must be negative. So we got this equation u equals to minus 0.76 x is depressed by k, as the density is we take the density on x axis, and this f 64.52, that is just that. So for maximum flow condition, we know that we can get the free flow speed when the jam density will be 0. So we apply this condition to the equation number 8. So on applying this, we put the k equals to 0 and we got the free flow speed as 64.52 kmph. Similarly, for jam density, we know that the jam density will be on the road when we will be having the free flow speed as 0. So we apply this condition and we got the jam density as 84.119 kmph. Then we know that maximum flow is nothing but this bit. Vf into Kg divided by 4. So we got 64.52 as you have value, we put it here. K is 84.119 divided by 4, we got the Q method 25 vehicle per hour. This is the reason for this given side of the data. Number 2, again we have given the observation for a mid block section and the data of density and speed is given. That is, density is given as 10, 40, 50, 81, 100, 30. Last one 120. And last one actually is the speed is given as 50, 35, 36, 25, 20, 45, 50. So in the similar way as we have solved the previous function, in the similar way we have solved it. But what is changed here? Here the given set of data for a mid-block section is given in between speed and density, and we are asked to form a model of the form of u equals to uf into e raised to minus k by km. We are asked to develop this model. We have this for a mid-block section, this data is given in between speed and density, and we are asked to develop a model of the form of u equals to uf into e raised to minus k by km, where the km is nothing but the jump density and k is simply the density. And uf is nothing but your free fall speed. This is what given, and we are asked to develop a model of that type. So we will solve the problem in the similar way as we have solved the previous problem. Again, we will as the density is on x-axis, we know for the infield model, so we will take the density as x-axis data, and the speed we will take as y-axis data, and we will solve it in the similar way. First of all, we will try to develop this polynomial number 3. What it will be is x square, so it will be the square of polynomial number 1. So it will be 100, 1600, 2500, then 6561. Then it is 10,000, 900, this is 144,000. Similarly, if we try to develop the column number 4, it will be the multiplication of column number 1 and column number 2. So it will be, first of all, first one it will be 500, second 1400, 1800, 2025. 2000, 1650, 1800. Similarly, we will take the summation of all these things. For the polynomial number 1, we will take the summation of this. So it will give the summation x. The summation x will be for this 431. And n will represent the number of data. Here the number of data are 7. Or to say the number of rows, the number of rows are 7. Similarly, the summation of column number 2 will give us summation y. This is 226. Summation of column number 3 will give us the summation of x squared. This is 36061. Similarly, summation xy. The summation of column number 4 will give us the summation of xy data. This will be 10875. In the similar way, we will try to develop the equation y equals to mx plus c. We will try further try to develop the equation from here. It will be summation y equals to m summation x plus nc. That's for this equation number 1. And another equation we can write, we can multiply by x on both sides, and we will get summation xy equals to m summation x square plus c summation x. We have all the values, that is summation y, summation x, and summation x and summation x square. We have already got all these values, so we will just put it and we will have the equation. So first equation will be summation y is nothing but 226 equals to m, and summation x is what? 431. So it will be 431m plus 7c. This is equation number 3. So the equation corresponding to equation number 2, it will be summation x y. This is 10875. Equals to m summation x square. Summation x square nothing but 36061 plus the summation x. Summation x is 431, so it will be 431c. This is equation number 4. Here we have two unknown parameters, that is m and t, and we have two equations. So we can, by solving this equation, we can get this unknown parameter. So on solving equation number 3 and 4, we get these two, that is m equals to, again we have noticed here that the value of m will be negative, it must be negative here, m will be minus 0.319 and t will be 51.94. So as we got the value of m and t, we can write the equation that y equals to minus mx plus c, or y equals to mx plus c, where value of m is negative, so minus 0.319 x plus 51.94. Here we know that data on y axis, the SP data we generate are represent on y axis, so y will be replaced by u minus 0.319, x will be replaced by the density, that is k plus 51.94, that's all the equation number 5. So we got the relation in between for the given kind of data, that is speed and density. Now we are solved, we need to develop that model, that is u plus u f into e raise to minus k by km, where km is the maximum density. So we have to solve it for maximum traffic flow conditions, or for maximum cap, or to say the power for the capacity conditions. So we will solve it for maximum traffic flow condition. For this maximum traffic flow, if you want to get the free flow speed, the free flow speed we will get when the jam density will be 0. We will apply this condition for the equation number 5. So from equation number 5, we will get u equals to, that is uf, equals to minus 0.319. at the place of k we have to put it 0, so we, as we are solving it for jam density, plus 51.94. so from here we got the free flow speed as 51.94 kmph. similarly we will solve it for the jam density. So when the condition for jam density will be, we'll get the jam density when the free flow speed will be 0. When the free flow speed will be 0, obviously the density will be the given the jam condition. So for this, the uf must be 0, or to say that u must be 0. We apply this condition to the equation number 5. So it will be 0 equals to minus 0.319 into kj plus 51.94. So from here we get the value of kj, that is jam density, as 162.31. vehicle per kilometer. So we have got the free flow speed as well the jam density, and we are asked to develop a model of a kind of u equals to uf into e raise to minus k by km. So we have already got the value of uf, so we will just substitute these values. What is uf? That is 51.94. to minus k by km, or to say the kj. Km is also representing the jam density, kj is also jam density, in left side it's km only here. It will not create any kind of confusion. So km is what? 162.31. This is that.